Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain CW radar with non-zero IF receiver in great details. Here I'll cover basics, block diagram and working of CW radar with non-zero IF receiver. Let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of CW radar with non-zero IF receiver. First of all, you need to understand what is the meaning of non-zero IF receiver. If you have zero IF receiver, then we don't have IF amplifier in receiver of radar system. Means with non-zero IF receiver system, we will be having IF amplifier in receiver of radar system. So here, first of all, you need to understand this. See, with given system, we have IF amplifier in the receiver of radar system. That's why name is CW radar with non-zero IF receiver, right? Now question is, why should we use IF amplifier in the receiver of radar system? That we use it to reduce flicker noise. If you use IF amplifier in the receiver of radar system, then we can reduce flicker noise. Let me explain you how. See, flicker noise, that is proportional to 1 divided by input frequency to the power alpha, where alpha is arbitrary constant and f in, that is input frequency signal of receiver. So flicker noise, that is inversely proportional to input frequency, that one can say, as if you consider alpha is equals to 1. So flicker noise is inversely proportional to frequency, right? If you have observed my last video based on CW radar system, in that we were not using IF amplifier in its receiver. See, with basic block diagram of CW radar system, with receiver over here, we don't have IF amplifier. And input frequency, that was FD. See, this FD is Doppler frequency. You can say that is beat frequency even. This beat frequency, that is there based on motion of the target. If target is there with higher motion, then value of FD will be higher. And target is there with lower motion, then value of FD will be lower. But this FD value, that is usually very small, right? See, this FD, that is input frequency to the receiver, and its value is ranging in between 100 Hz to 1000 Hz. So that is quite low. And as this FD value is lower, flicker noise is higher with this given system. So now we will be upgrading this continuous wave radar system with non-zero IF receiver. This is basic block diagram, right? In which we will be having higher flicker noise as well as there are some issues of isolation. Now we will be upgrading block diagram of CW radar system with non-zero IF receiver. If you observe block diagram, then here we have two antennas. One is for transmitter and second is for receiver. If you use two antenna system, then you will be providing excellent isolation in between transmitter and receiver. One should know transmitter is working at very high power and receiver is receiving very weak signal. So there has to have isolation in between transmitter and receiver circuit. And ideal situation is two separate antennas. One is for transmitter and second is for receiver. So here we are using two separate antennas by which ideal separation that can be provided, or you can say ideal isolation that can be provided in between transmitter and receiver. Here we have transmitter circuit. With the use of transmitter circuit, we will be transmitting high power signal with frequency F0, and here we have receiver circuit where received echo signal that will be having frequency F0 plus or minus FD. This plus or minus FD, that is deviation in frequency that happens based on motion of the target. If target is having velocity V, then deviation in frequency will be 2V by lambda, that I have derived in my last videos. Right, you just go through it. Here, input to the mixture that is having frequency F0 plus or minus FD, and second signal is having frequency f0 plus fi. And this mixer will be taking difference of these two over here. So that difference will be cancelling f0, and here will be having frequency that is fi plus or minus fd. This fi, that is intermediate frequency. That intermediate frequency value is way higher compared to fd. I have told you value of fd that lies in between 100 hertz to 1000 hertz. While this fi, that is way greater than that. You can say it is there in terms of few kilohertz, right? So here we are having input signal frequency that is now higher. Previously it was fd. Now input frequency is higher means flicker noise will be lower. Flicker noise, that is inversely proportional to input frequency. So here we are having higher input frequency, because of which now with the use of this upgraded block diagram of CW radar, we'll be having lower flicker noise, right? So here input frequency of receiver, that is fi plus or minus fd, based on that we'll be having lower value of flicker noise. Here we have second detector which is used to identify value of fd, and based on deviation in frequency this system can identify velocity of target, right? So this is what about receiver of this system. Now let us talk about transmitter of this system. See here, this is the basic transmitter circuit in which we will be transmitting high power signal with frequency f0, where here we have one mixer. With this mixer we have two inputs. One is having frequency f0 and second is having frequency fi. This fi, that is intermediate frequency, and after mixer we will be having three different bands. One is center, that is having frequency f0, and two side bands are there, f0 plus fi and f0 minus fi. So here we have three different bands. After that we are using one sideband filter over here. If you use sideband filter, let us say that is having bandwidth of f0 plus fi, then other bands will get rejected over here. So here after sideband filter, at receiver side, second input to this mixer is having frequency f0 plus fi. So here at transmitter, we transmit f0 with high power over here, and this f0 that we give it to mixer along with fi, and based on that we'll be having three bands over here, right? Those three bands are f0, f0 plus fi and f0 minus fi. After using sideband filter, we'll be having f0 plus fi, that is second input to this receiver mixer, right? So that is how transmitter and receiver block diagram is there. I hope you have understood this. So here basic agenda of this non-zero IF receiver is to have lower flicker noise as well as better isolation. Here we provide two separate antennas which provides better isolation, and with the use of IF amplifier we have reduction in flicker noise with given radar system. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.